Sí, Lucien, que co Hello viewers, welcome to Lemu TV, a station where you watch and learn. I'm your teacher, Philary Street. Today we're going to look at English from 4, lesson 5. Our topic will be listening and speaking, and subtopic, the etiquette. So welcome, and first let's look at the objective. We expect that by the end of the lesson you'll be able to define an etiquette, describe how to interact politely, describe also how to disagree politely. So we can start with definition of an etiquette. You can say, etiquette is the correct or polite behavior in a society or among members of a particular profession. In a conversation you may agree, question or disagree. Can you look at the instances of interruption? If you didn't hear what the speaker said, you interrupt. When you wish the speaker to clarify certain facts which are not clear to you. When you feel the speaker has overlooked certain significant facts. When the speaker has misrepresented certain known facts. When you strongly disagree with the speaker, and when you strongly agree and wish to support the speaker. How do you interrupt? Use polite language to introduce an interruption. In a meeting, all the interruptions should be channeled through the chair. Avoid interrupting a speaker when in mid-sentence. In an interruption, personal feelings should not be overriding reason for interrupting a speaker. Disagree with the speaker, with what the speaker says, and not the person. Remember, interrupting is a matter of attitude and is best expressed through body language and tone. That's why it's more than a verbal exercise. So when disagreeing, also the most polite way to disagree with someone is to introduce your disagreement by doing the following. Apologize before introducing your disagreement. Show that you understand the other person's opinion. And how do you interrupt politely? The following are the ways of interrupting politely. Use words such as, may I ask, if I may say so, pardon me, but, do you mind, 1 minute, sir, allow me to say, excuse me, I beg your pardon, but, then you interrupt with what you want to say, courteously. And you can also continue, use the word, perhaps you could say, another one, I'm afraid I don't agree with maybe what the speaker says. Another one, have you considered... another one, let us look at it this way. Another one, on the contrary. And the last one, with your permission, I would like to point out that. Those are the examples of words that we use when we want to agree. Remember, as we have said, your tone or your body language can speak for itself. Having said that, check on the assignment. You are talking with your friend about tribalism. Unfortunately, you disagree but interrupt politely even when disagreeing with him or her. Write a conversation that may have taken place. You can refer the lesson on etiquette to Excelling in English, Students Book 4, second edition, published by the Kenya Literature Bureau. You can as well contact us on SMS line on your screen, YouTube Elimu TV, Facebook Elimu TV, Twitter @ElimuTV_KE. Thank you for the lesson.